HCVMA, Chapter 10, Question Number 61. Suppose the particle of the previous problem has mass m and speed v before the collision, and it sticks to the rod after the collision. The rod has mass capital M. A. Find the velocity of the center of mass C of the system constituting the rod plus the particle. B. Find the velocity of the particle with respect to C before the collision. C. Find the velocity of the rod with respect to C before the collision. D. Find the angular momentum of the particle and the rod about the center of mass C before the collision. E. Find the moment of inertia of the system about the vertical axis through the center of mass C after the collision. F. Find the velocity of the center of mass C and the angular velocity of the system about the center of mass after the collision. Velocity of the center of mass is given by summation of mass into velocity divided by summation of mass. Putting the values, we get m into v plus capital M into 0 divided by m plus capital M. Thus, velocity of center of mass is mv divided by m plus capital M. This is answer to part A of the question. Since the particle is moving with speed v, its speed with respect to the center of mass is v minus mv divided by m plus capital M. Simplifying, we get capital M into v divided by m plus capital M. This is answer to part B of the question. Since the rod was initially at rest, its velocity with respect to the center of mass is equal in magnitude to the speed of the center of mass, but in opposite direction. Thus, velocity of the rod with respect to the center of mass is mv divided by m plus capital M. This is answer to part C of the question. The distance of the center of mass from the line of motion of the particle is m into 0 plus capital M into L by 2 divided by m plus capital M. Simplifying, we get capital M into L divided by 2 into m plus capital M. Therefore, the angular momentum of the particle about the center of mass is m into its velocity with respect to the center of mass into perpendicular distance of the line of motion of the particle from the center of mass. Putting the values, we get m into capital M into v divided by m plus capital M into capital M into L divided by 2 into m plus capital M. Simplifying, we get capital M square into mvl divided by 2 into m plus capital M whole square. The distance of line of motion of center of rod from the center of mass of the system is L by 2 minus R, or L by 2 minus capital M into L divided by 2 into M plus capital M. Simplifying, we get M into L divided by 2 into M plus capital M. Since before the collision, in the frame of center of mass, the rod was in pure translation, its angular momentum about the center of mass of the system is capital M into its velocity with respect to center of mass into distance of line of motion from the center of mass. Putting the values, we get capital M into mv divided by m plus capital M into ml divided by 2 into m plus capital M. Simplifying, we get m square capital mvl divided by 2 into m plus capital M whole square. If you do not know how to calculate the angular momentum of a system, watch our video on calculation of angular momentum. The link for the video is shown on the screen. The moment of inertia of particle about the axis is m into distance square. Putting the value, we get m into capital M square L square divided by 4 into m plus capital M whole square. The moment of inertia of the rod about the axis passing through its center is given by 1 by 12 capital M L square. If you do not know how to arrive at this result, watch our video on calculation of moment of inertia of a rod. The link for the video is shown on the screen. Applying the parallel axis theorem, we get the moment of inertia of the rod about the axis passing through the center of mass of the system is equal to 1 by 12 capital ML square plus capital M into distance between the axis square, or 1 by 12 capital ML square plus capital M into M square L square divided by 4 into M plus capital M whole square. Adding both the moment of inertia, we get 1 by 12 ML square plus capital M into M square L square divided by 4 into M plus capital M whole square, plus m into capital M square L square divided by 4 into m plus capital M whole square. Simplifying, we get capital M into capital M plus 4m into L square divided by 12 into m plus capital M whole square. This is answer to part E of the question. Since there is no external force acting on the system, both the velocity of the center of mass and its angular momentum must be conserved. Therefore, the velocity of its center of mass after the collision is equal to the velocity before collision, that is mv divided by m plus capital M. In the frame of the center of mass, initial angular momentum of the system before collision is capital M square into mvl divided by 2 into m plus capital M whole square plus capital M into m square vl divided by 2 into m plus M whole square. If omega be the angular speed of the system after the collision, then this angular momentum must be equal to capital M into capital M plus 4m into L square divided by 12 into m plus capital M into omega. Simplifying, we get omega is equal to 6mv divided by capital M plus 4m into L. This is answer to part F of the question. In order to request solution to any question from HC Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. You may like to watch solution to other questions from this chapter. The link for the playlist is shown on the screen. Check out our videos on theories, tools and techniques of physics. The playlist is shown on the screen. Subscribe the channel and like our Facebook page for latest updates.